Hi everyone, so in this video we'll start talking about MongoDB, how to add this MongoDB in our application. Okay, before that we'll just have a quick overview on what we have done in the last video. We had this simple store in the service and we were able to do create, update, delete. Okay, earlier there was an error right at this line because it was constant, so I removed it to a let, because constant you can't assign the reference again. And this is pretty much working fine. Okay, so this is the delete method, create, update, post. Now what we will do is we will introduce a mongoose. Mongoose is actually an npm module which is required for us to support the to connect the MongoDB database and then query from its collections. So MongoDB is a NoSQL database, not same as what we have in the MySQL, Postgres and Oracle DB, because it is storing the documents in your collections. Documents are like JSON based, they don't have their own schema. If you wanted to explore what is this NoSQL database or document based MongoDB database, then you can explore much. So to get started, we have to install first Mongoose in this project. Once MongoDB is started, we need to have just a MongoDB up and running somewhere. Okay, and then we can just write our code connecting to the MongoDB. So for that we can have one DB file here, controller services, because services will be talking to that, but here we'll have a database file, and here you can put index.js. And we can just have the simple snippet. Here we have requiring Mongoose, and here we are connecting to the test database. Okay, this is my MongoDB URL. Once the connection is done, I will be able to get it. If you are not able to connect to it, then you will get an error, because right now I don't have a MongoDB database server running, Mongo server running. I will be running that on maybe on Docker containers separate somewhere. So I should be able to talk here. You can just require this database. So in app.js on top, okay, now when you just see this, you can see we are getting error because we are not able to connect to that particular port which it is looking for, Mongo network error, right? So what we need to do, we just need to have a MongoDB running somewhere on that particular port. So that is just a basic installation, like how to get started with a MongoDB. Now we have to write a MongoDB schema models. How MongoDB schema models look like is, we have to create like user store. We wanted to have user store, will have a username, email ID, password, all these things, and we should be able to update that data in the database. So in the database itself, we can create models, and I can just have user.js, and this is a simple model, simple structure of creating a model. So some model schema, so let's replace it to user model schema, and here I'm going to have username. Like you define a table in MySQL, right? Similarly, we are actually defining our attributes. Whatever you wanted to add. So this is a user model schema, and my model is user. So this model will represent this in the database, and we can just export it directly. So this mongoose.schema we are getting, or you can just directly say mongoose.schema. That is also fine, and we can have a const instead of these where. So we have created a mongoose schema, and this Mongoose schema is being represented with the user model. So in the user collection, you can say in the MongoDB database, we are trying to have a three different JSON attributes: username, email, and host. Host is means like to which, from which IP this host is connected, nothing else. You can have any other additional attributes, whatever you want. So these three attributes I have in the basic schema. Now what we will do is we will try to write an operations to this particular schema. Okay, so we have to just take care of few things, like username should be of type string, email is of type string. You can also add a schema validations here, that username minimum username string should have a length, email should be of type email and all, because that is request validation. We are not going to put the garbage data in our database. So those things. So in this video, what we have done is we have added the MongoDB database connection details, right? And second thing is we have created our model. Now from the APIs, first of all, we have to get our MongoDB server running so that we are able to connect to this MongoDB. Second thing is we can start writing our APIs. Now from the service layer, instead of just depending on this mock data, we can just directly get the database model, and we can just do it like this. So const users require, this is how we are going to do it. So I'll just talk about it. So database models for user. So this is actually representing user model. So instead of doing get user, we can just say user dot find by ID. This will return promise, so we have to deal with that. We have to write appropriate code to manage the things. Here this is the create user, so we have to create a object of that user first, and then user dot insert or user dot save. Here also user dot find by email ID. So here you can just pass the custom parameters if you want to filter based on particular condition like email, and here you pass your email string. So we'll talk about Mongoose, which is ORM for MongoDB database. I mean, we are using Mongoose to fetch the data from the database, and then what all different queries we can write here.